folks. Welcome to this week's episode of Cooking with Mario. You know, in light of the reception that we got of some previous episodes on foods that heal or healthy eating, we're going to crank it up with the third episode of foods that are good for you. You may or may not know about these everyday foods, but they pack up a powerful health benefits for you. You got to be using these foods. We're going to talk about today is coffee. We're going to talk about cabbage and onions. Stay tuned and learn about the medicinal aspects of these everyday foods right in your house. Right back with Chef Mario.
A good shower doesn't just cleanse your body. It refreshes your spirit. Now, the Delta Faucet Company introduces H2O Kinetic Technology. As the first to bring this revolutionary technology to market, the Delta Faucet Company has created a groundbreaking union of organics and science. One that completely reinvents the showering experience. Each spray contains specially designed chambers that ingeniously control the water's shape, velocity, and thermal dynamics. As the water is sculpted into an undulating stream, droplets retain a consistent size, shape, and density. The larger droplets created by H2O Kinetic Technology retain heat better, while an innovative spray pattern provides more complete body coverage. H2O Kinetic Technology offers the feeling of a high-flow shower, but uses less water. Vast, luxurious droplets. A drenching spray. And an all-enveloping warmth that comforts the very soul. It's a shower experience like no other. Featuring H2O Kinetic Technology. Brought to you by the Delta Faucet Company.
Hi, I'm Jim Corvino, Certified Tax Resolution Specialist. The first sign of a business being in trouble with the IRS is that they cannot make their payroll tax deposits. You must remember, a husband and wife owning a business are both officers or owners of the business, perhaps partners. Each is a responsible party and each will be blamed by the IRS for owing this money. Therefore, having one spouse own and operate the business is an advantage. Additionally, all check signers can be responsible as the IRS conducts discovery to find out who willfully or through neglect has omitted paying the payroll taxes.
Never again worry about leaving the garage door open or the front door unlocked. Your mobile app can also send system alerts to your phone for both alarm and non-alarm events. So of course you'll know about emergencies such as fire, medical, or break-in alarms, but you can also receive push notifications for non-emergency events that help with your everyday life. For example, I personally know right away when my kids get home from school every day. Make sure your home is powered by Alarm.com for ultimate access and awareness wherever you may be.
Welcome back, folks, to the kitchen here. You know, I took a break from cooking some sort of dish today because I really want to talk about, you know, how to make not only your kitchen better and you better as a cook, but your body better as a machine. You know, I believe that we live in the day of information. You know, have you ever heard that term, ignorance is bliss? It's not true. You ever hear the other term of, you know, what you don't know won't hurt you? That ain't true either. What you don't know can and will hurt you. So in this age of information, the internet and all these other sources that we get our data from, what is the right data? Well, nobody's really telling us what's going on with food, you know, at the local market or, you know, on local TV. I'd like to share some things that I believe are very beneficial to you getting better health. Because if you want to feed your family and be a better cook or be a better person in society, you got to be healthy. You really do. You got to have energy. So how do we get energy? Coffee. Now, coffee, I know, has gotten a bad rap over the years. You know, all the health food people are saying, you know, don't drink coffee, got caffeine in it, it's bad for you, you know, this and that. And mind you, there are some few minor negative aspects of drinking too much coffee. You know, if you drink too much coffee, you're going to affect the, you know, the Three Musketeers mineral aspect. That would be calcium, magnesium, and zinc. you know, if you drink too much, it will deplete your body of those three. However, if you drink one or two cups a day of coffee, the research is definitely in your favor. You know, coffee, as far as I'm concerned, has enormous health benefits. Just last week, my daughter, you know, gets up in the morning and she's like a zombie. She's 16 years old. She's the average teenager. And she drank a cup of coffee. And I'll tell you what, the last week or two, she has been perky in the morning, 5:30, and energetic. And she can talk to you better and reason with you better. Why is that? I noticed. You know, coffee. It increases your memory. Did you know that? Studies have proven the more coffee you drink, the more you can remember. It also prevents depression. You know, if you find yourself down and out and the gray weather's got you all, you know, upset about things, drink a cup of coffee. Now, I didn't say put 4 pounds of sugar and 2 quarts of milk in it. Coffee, like this. You can add a little sweetener, but don't add all the other stuff with it. You know, all those creamer additives, international this, and, you know, all these fancy latte, mocha, schmochas. Forget all that. Just coffee. Keep it simple. You know, it boosts your metabolism. Did you know that more coffee you drink, the more energy you get? And if your metabolism is boosted, you're going to have weight loss. Coffee contains, you know, a lot of polyphenolic qualities, a lot of antioxidants that help you, especially with your blood sugar. So if coffee improves your blood sugar, ultimately it's going to affect, you know, the negative aspects of diabetes. Believe it or not, there's studies that prove that diabetes and drinking coffee, there's a great benefit to it. You know, coffee increases your mental function. I've noticed in the morning when I drink a cup of coffee before work and I eat a little piece after some nice toast or something, a little piece of dark chocolate and black coffee, my mental function is through the roof. I'll tell you, folks, you do that, you're going to be ready to take the SATs to get into Harvard. This stuff is great for you. Coffee is really one of nature's cure-alls, one of a gift from God. You know the coffee is actually in the Bible? I'm not kidding you. I believe Jesus drank coffee. He wrote a whole book about it. It's called Hebrews. Well, maybe not. Anyway, coffee is excellent for you. You know, protects against colon cancer. You know, it helps reduction of Parkinson's disease and actually prevents liver disease. Coffee has enormous diuretic effects, meaning that if you're not regular and you drink one or two, you know, cups of black coffee or slightly sweetened coffee, I promise you, you're going to eliminate. You're going to get the toxins out of your lower intestine, your colons. You know, I read a book years ago that said that when John Wayne, the famous cowboy, you know, back in the day, the Hollywood actor, when he died, they did an autopsy on him and they found 4 pounds of undigested red meat in his lower intestine. I'll tell you what, I think that coffee would have gotten rid of that poison that led to his demise. And we talked last week about Dr. Salisbury, the Salisbury steak, and he prescribed coffee during the Civil War with, you know, the Salisbury steak to remedy things like diarrhea, ingestional problems, and dysentery, etc. Coffee. I'm telling you, you got to start drinking some coffee in balance. Remember, life's about balance. And I'll tell you, it's all about what you put into your body. You know, we're in a society where everything's fast-paced and push-button and fast food, and we're really out of balance. Too much grease, too much fried foods, too much carbohydrates and junk. America, we're killing ourselves. We have to stop and take inventory of this incredible machine God gave us. You know, you can't go to the buffet and you can't have everything on the buffet. You can't come back with crab legs and Russian dressing and steaks and desserts and all these different drinks. You're doing your body a disservice. You've got to slow down. You've got to eat simpler. You've got to eat smaller, more multiple meals to a more optimum, better, healthy you. And how do you do that? You incorporate great raw foods into your diet. I'm all about eating some junk food now and then and treating your kids on Friday nights, no problem, but be balanced and let's eat some good raw foods. One raw food, I'll tell you folks, that is enormous benefit to your life and your body is cabbage. I'll tell you, those Irish people, they got it going on. When they make that corned beef and cabbage, there's a lot of science behind that. It's not only the taste, but there's a lot of science. When you make Chinese use cabbage, Pennsylvania Dutch use cabbage, Polish Ukrainians use cabbage, they roll it with the pigs in a blanket, you name it. But I'll tell you, the best way to eat cabbage is raw. Cabbage is part of the cruciferous family. Cruciferous, however you want to say it. It's the broccoli, the cabbage, and the Brussels sprout family. you know, some of the excellent attributes of cabbage is it's very low calorie. Low calories, meaning that you can eat a whole, you know, 3, 4, 5 ounces of chopped cabbage, raw or cooked, and it'll give you about 20 or 30 calories. People have been known to go on cabbage diets. If you want to cleanse, an excellent way to cleanse your body of toxins and impurities is through cabbage. You know, cabbage is very versatile, not only in its culinary aspects, but also in its medicinal aspects. You know, cabbage contains high quantities of bioflavonoids. There's a word you haven't heard in a while, bioflavonoids. Vitamin C is another attribute of cabbage. Did you know that there's more vitamin C in cabbage in a serving twice as much as the average navel orange? Isn't that amazing? We always think that oranges is a king of vitamin C. Cabbage, folks, right here. We got vitamin K in it. We got vitamin B6. All these essential minerals to make your body function right, your brain function capacity, your heart capacity, your circulatory system. It's loaded with folate. It's an amazing, amazing product, cabbage. Some of the benefits of cabbage is it treats constipation. You know what, today with the stress that we have and the lack of digestive foods, good foods that we're eating, you know, people are, you know, they're bound up, you know, they're stressed out. And you got it, prunes are great, I guess, but cabbage is one you could swallow better than prunes sometimes. Cabbage also helps eliminate headaches naturally. If you've got, you know, migraine headaches, you might want to start eating cabbage. Eat it in its raw form. Remember, every time we put heat to something, we kill its minerals. We deplete its vitamins. Most of the times you want to eat your stuff raw. You know, in this case, cabbage for headaches. Cabbage also helps reduce obesity. You know, the more cabbage you eat, scientifically they've proven that the minerals and the vitamins in cabbage do something to your metabolic system. Now, mind you, I'm no doctor, but I do know that my mother and father have raised me on health foods and organic foods back when I was a kid. They've been involved with that for over 50 or 60 years. They're in their 70s. None of them doctor, none of them nurse. My parents don't take medicines. They're slim, they're slender, they're energetic. How is that? The stuff you put in your body. The stuff that, right here, this raw stuff. Now, if you want to eat cabbage, you got to eat organic cabbage. Why? Grows in the ground, like potatoes, on top of the ground. Remember, everything that you put into the ground, this soil today, you know, it absorbs into the food, obviously. And potatoes are a big culprit. Cabbage is another one. You want to eat organic cabbage for the health purposes. It also prevents heart disease. I have a story about cabbage, 30 seconds. Years ago, I dated a girl in high school or post-high school, right around that time, and she was a very nice girl from Philadelphia, and she had a terrible digestive condition called ulcerative colitis. You might have heard that before. Fancy term for meaning bleeding ulcers on your lower intestine or your colon. And boy, did she doctor. She was on steroids. She was in and out of the hospital. She had weight loss, weight gain, mood swings. I mean, her whole track was just out of sorts. And my mother, who is very nutritionally minded, took her to a very renowned nutritionist named Mr. Wade. He was the most renowned nutritionist in Philadelphia of the day. He's brilliant. He's passed now. Mr. Wade, believe it or not, told her to get this cabbage organic, cut it in half, and put it through one of those carrot juicers. And he said, you drink one glass of raw cabbage every day for 2 weeks. It'll help and even cure your bleeding ulcers. And we all looked back and said, wow, that sounds crazy, but let's give it a try. She did it. She drank organic cabbage juice, and it smelled awful, I'll be honest with you. But if you can stomach it, it absolutely cured her chronic condition of ulcerative colitis. That's real testimony, folks. Look it up. Look it up on the internet or call someone who cares and find out about this awesome medicinal qualities of cabbage. And finally, cabbage is an anti-inflammatory. You know, it helps with joint pain. It helps with inflammation of your joints. It relieves that. And it's all about getting better. It's all about curing. It's all about, you know, ingesting the good things. You ever hear that expression, an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure? Here's the preventive medicine we're talking about. Maybe you've got all kinds of health conditions. I don't know. But it's never too late to start. And if you're young and if you're not, nursing or doctoring for something, these are the foundational foods that you need to start using in your daily diet. Foods that heal, foods that are healthy. And let's get away from the drive-thru for a night or two, come back to the house, keep it simple, and help your family be a better, healthier family. On that note, I'll be right back in a minute or two to show you the last segment of this episode. You ain't gonna believe what this common food does for your family and how you need to start eating this stuff yesterday. Be right back with this next segment.
Looking for a medical alert system for home? You can stop looking and select the best. Help.me offers the latest technology and the best prices with reliable and fast call center action. When accident or illness strikes or tries to sideline you, you will never be alone with Help.me. Whether you are an active single traveling the country or a stay-at-home senior, this system will give you the confidence to live alone, knowing that if you ever need help, it's just one push of a button away. For more information, please give us a call today or visit us online.
If you want to play golf, you shouldn't have to wait for a tee time. At Sawmill Golf Course, you don't need a tee time, and your green fees are always good for unlimited play. Sawmill Golf Course has been keeping golf affordable and enjoyable for 30 years. Play golf in Sawmill's relaxed and friendly atmosphere. Enjoy breathtaking scenery. Stop in for a drink after your round. At Sawmill, you're always in the company of friends. For more information, give us a call or visit us online today.
Hello, I'm Tamara Verweis, Certified Tax Resolution Specialist with a tax tip for you. If you haven't filed your taxes in years, or you have back year taxes that you've missed, you should file them immediately and stop the late filing penalty.
For more information on how to handle your tax situation in the most professional manner, call Corvino and Verweis or visit us online today.
Back here with the last leg of the episode of Foods That Heal. We talked about coffee. We talked about cabbage. I want to talk to you about something that I'm telling you got to have in your diet every day. You may or may not like it, but it's powerful. It belongs to you. It's the secret to your health and success. Onions. Oh, Mario, I hate onions. They make my breath stink. They make me repeat. You know, I smell like some kind of hoagie shop when I go to the office. I get it. I get there's negative aspects to the onions. Let me tell you something. This family of onions, garlic, radishes, hot peppers, things of that nature, those crunchy, spicy kind of, you know, vegetables, they're like kryptonite. I'm telling you, for your body. And you have to put these in your diet like yesterday. You know, did you know that your body is 70% sulfur? Your whole body is sulfur, water. Fluids constantly in motion, cleansing and filtering through your liver. You know, did you know that onions contain a very, you know, high percentage of organic sulfur? And you know, it's been proven that sulfur is a blood purifying process. So your blood every day needs purifying. You putting garbage in, we got the stuff in the air and all the negative aspects of preservatives and stress. You need to cleanse your blood on a daily basis. You know, onions are rich in chromium, you know, in the family of chromium picolinate. It's been proven that onions help regulate your blood sugar. Back to that diabetes thing again. You know, you ever hear about chromium picolinate? You need to do some research on it, because chromium's in this stuff here. And it's, you know, if you're sticking yourself with needles and insulin and this and that, and you're up and down with your moods and your blood, you need to start eating some more onions. And that's a fact. You know, they're super, super powerful. They're high in vitamin C. Super high in vitamin C. They're high in B6. They're high in fiber. You know, makes you full, makes you regular, keeps things flowing. You know, onions naturally eliminate free radicals. Free radicals, there's little critters that get in your body and they war against your cells. Your whole body's about cells. So they war against your cells and they cause cancer and other degenerative diseases. Onions are the critters that get inside, a little Pac-Man inside your body, and they eat those bad boys in your body. You gotta eat these onions. I'm telling you, they're super for you. It reduces, believe it or not, it's been proven to reduce tumors and certain elements of cancer with the antibiotic properties and the antioxidant qualities of onions, along with that sulfur. It's kind of like a grand mixture of things in your body. It also has been proven to reduce blood clots in your system, thus reducing, heart disease and untimely, heart attacks and seizures and things of that nature. You gotta eat onions raw most of the times. I'm not talking about putting fried onions on your greasy cheeseburger. You gotta get away from that. You gotta chop it up, you gotta put it in salsa. You gotta put it on your salads. You gotta eat generous portions of onions on a daily basis. Maybe like a quarter cup of onions throughout the course of the day or so would do your body really good. Did you know that these onions have enormous impact on the environment? I could take this onion right now. I can cut that onion in half. And I can put it in the air and just sit it there. And you say, well, what's that do for you, Mario? It does a lot. Did you know that that onion exposed like it, now that I've revealed its super powerful internal properties by cutting its shield off, this onion now becomes an attractor for all sorts of toxins and bacteria and pathogens that are microscopically floating in your air, in your atmosphere. Can you believe that? That's what onions do. They have a super air filtration powers and abilities. Did you know if you get, from a medicinal perspective, you get onions and you put them in slices, get this, and you stick them in your socks at night when you go to bed, put them on your feet. This sounds crazy, I know, it's something out of some kind of a Frankenstein book, I get it. But this is where the ancient healing happens, in the Indian culture, the Chinese culture, and Far East, etc. You put that stuff in your feet. The bottom of your feet have meridian points, and each one of those meridian points equates to a certain part in your body, whether it's your liver, or your head, or your digestive tract, whatever. And when you put them onions on your feet at night, and let your feet absorb that onion, it heals enormous things in your body. You know, one of them is earaches or headaches, intestinal digestive issues. Put those onions on your feet at night and see what happens. You know, when I was a kid, my mother used to slice onions in big rings, and if I was sick at night, and she would put onions in a rag and put that t-shirt rag on my chest and then put the blanket over, and I went to bed at night, and if I had some sort of cold or influenza, I promise you the next morning, it was gone because of onions. Here's another super duper idea with onions. You make the slices and you get, and you get that onion with the juice. You see that slimy juice that's there? That's what you want. You rub that on your neck around your thyroid area. Rub it generously and keep it on there and go to bed at night. If you have thyroid problems, even thyroid cancer, there are properties in the onions that will help heal and regulate your thyroid. It's proven. You got to do the research. Again, I'm not a doctor, and I'm not saying, don't doctor. I'm saying if you're tired of the pills, you're tired of the non-effects of the medicine you're getting now or the treatment you're getting now, you got to go back to nature. And onions is where it's at. You know, one of the most powerful parts of onions is actually in the skin. And you can take this inner skin part here, and this is where all those antioxidants are, and bioflavonoids, and anti-inflammatory properties are right there in that yellowish film. Now, when you get these onion skins, this is incredible, and you chop them in little pieces, and then you shred them like little tiny pieces, and you put hot water on them and make like an onion tea, that's a whole nother program. And just a few things, when you make an onion tea, it's been known to help with skin issues like eczema and rosacea. You get 2 cups of hot water, boil it, pour it over your onion skins, let it sit for an hour or two, take 2-3 tablespoons a day of that stuff, it's gonna help you. Onion skin tea with a little sweetener, with a tablespoon every 6 hours, will help your baby naturally with colic or when your baby's colicky. Onion skin tea also helps. It's been proven scientifically to improve your bone density. It also helps with sores around your mouth. It also, last but not least, helps you with fungus issues. You got toenail fungus, you got fungus in your fingers, you know, there's fungus among us. Onions are your answer. They're a powerful source of antimicrobial, antibacterial components in this incredible natural product. I'll tell you what, folks, I went down on a trip to South Carolina a few months back, and I was there for 5 days. And somehow or another, I got off my regime, and I didn't have onions, I didn't have garlic and radishes on a daily basis. When I came back, I was ready for the hospital. That's how sick I was. I got in this environment, and I was without my onions, I was without my garlic, and these people down there, they didn't eat it, and I didn't want to push it on them because I was cooking for them, but I didn't have this stuff. I was deadly sick. My wife and I, my kids, we hardly ever get sick. I got sick once in the last 4 years, because when you put this stuff in your body, the critters can't live in you. I'm telling you, it might be offensive to some people. You might get bad breath, and you might say, oh, I don't like the way it tastes and all. Learn to like it, because your body's worth it. Your time is worth it. You know, you only got one life to live. Put the good stuff in your system. I'll tell you what, we've got great, great information here. I hope you validate it by going out there in a third party and figuring out how can I incorporate this stuff into my diet. I really care about you. I want you to feel great. I want to hear your feedback at the deli, on the internet. If I see you down at the bank or the grocery store, say hi and tell me what these products have done for you and how this show has made a difference. I really appreciate you checking in with us. Mario at Newburgh Deli. Check us out at newburghdeli.com. Hope you come in and have a cheesesteak on me. And, you know, tell me how these products, again, have made a difference in your life. This is, again, Mario. Thanks for tuning in. I'll see you next episode. I appreciate all you do. God bless you and God bless America.